Hey guys, how you doing? My name is Jonathan Mortimer. I'm a freelance animator and storyboard artist currently based in sunny Scotland. For the past few years, I've been using Toon products internationally for animated films and for games. Today, I've been asked to bring you tutorials on how to use Harmony Essentials. Hope you enjoy it, guys. Let's get started.
Hi guys, how you doing? My name is Jonathan Mortimer. I've been asked by Toon to show you my style of animation, inspired by my short film, 43, that's currently on the Toon Boom Showcase. Let's get started. So I'm just going to open up Harmony. So here's my scene ready to go. What I like to do is I actually like to work with the red or the blue colour just to kind of create a quick sketch. So how about I start off by left clicking onto that layer and change the name to sketch. This means that you and I can be kept on the same track. We're going to left click on one of the keyframes to then start our drawing. I like to sketch with the paintbrush. You can sketch with the pencil tool if you wish. I like the brush tool because I'm using an interactive tablet and I like the pressure sensitivity of it, so I can give me a nice free flowing hand like so. Good stuff. So what I'm going to do to get us started is, well, let's have a little chat and talk about what we can do for our drawings. I have no idea if you guys are experienced animators or not. It doesn't really make much of a difference. If you're approaching this from a beginner's point of view, you may want to have a wee chat about or how we think about explosive and implosive artists. So for example, if we just do a nice little quick sketch here. If I started off with the face and then started working inward like so, you could say that's an implosive artist because you're starting out with the outline and then going to make your character. Okay guys, let's take a little step out here and have a little chat about different approaches or methodologies to drawing your character. We could, as far as that was explained to me, was we have two different types of artists. We have implosive artists that starts on the outside, the outline, and works into all the finer details. We also have explosive artists that start out with maybe a nose or a certain feature and work outward. It's entirely up to yourself which one you are. I'm just letting you know that there's two different ways of doing it, possibly even more. So don't worry about if I'm doing something different from what you've been shown or anything else. I'm going to start off my drawing basically with some of the details. So you could call me in this tutorial, you can think of me as an explosive artist. So I might start off with an eye. Little quick sketch. I like working with vectors, so I could actually, if I wanted to, take this eye and flip it to the other side, but I'm going to sketch out. Another great reason I use vectors is that I could control A to select it and I could reposition it and scale it without losing definition, so I can make it a nice big close-up or shrink it down. Something you should keep in mind, guys. So we'll carry on doing this. Make the other eye. Don't worry too much about the space between the eyes because, as I said, because it's a vector, we can actually change it. Okay, and where's the light coming in from that one? The nose. Everyone's going to have their own style of how they want to do the nose. This is mine. Start up here. Okay, so let's... Nice big eyebrows to work with. It's a bit too big, so how about we... if we transform it and scale it down a little bit. So you can get all of it in, or most of it in. So this character's going to need a mouth, so let's just give him a... little quick one. Let's him out a little bit. And then I can start working around his head. Let's see. And once again, guys, don't worry about how things are looking. I can even show you now what we can do to edit and change this. So let's select these lines. We can hold shift to select both. And now we have a bit more freedom to start pulling these lines in. If we're not happy with it there, we can move it back up and forth. Yeah, that's not too bad like that for now. I'm sure you guys will spend more time working on your characters than I'm doing this one now. Just to give you a nice quick introduction to maybe how you want to approach these characters. Okay. Our character needs some ears. One. Two. And what I like to do with my characters is I like to just continue up. I like to draw the rest of the head. Okay. We can shift it and skew it just to match up, so don't worry about if it's not perfect. We can change it, we can edit it. Nothing is forever. Let's scale this back down again. Okay, so here's the start of my sketch. Not too bad, it's okay. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to press the padlock key to lock up that layer. I'm now going to go to the plus sign and add a new drawing layer. And this one I'm going to call refined and press add and close. It will still give me a faint outline of what I'd created before. That's great. This is just a sketch. Give us the rough basis so I can still edit and change this if I wish. It's just going to be a guide. So when I use the black color, still in my paintbrush, we can still refine the brush. We can go in and we can start drawing this bad boy out. Let's see. So that's where the light's hitting his eye. Nice big eyebrows. We can curve his head ever so slightly in and back out for the cheek to give it a bit more of a realistic appearance. Oh look, just kind of give it a slight point, if you want. And put one for his ear. Good stuff. We can move up to the head. Let's pull this back a little bit to have a wee think. It's entirely up to yourself what you'd like to do for your characters. Here, I'm just going to give my character bit of length in his hair and we can just quickly give this character some hair. Yeah, that's pretty cool. We'll go with that. We can still edit and refine this. You can still see the red outline, but that's basically how I start off making my characters. From this point, and then I'd add some colour. I can then even change and refine it so that I've got basically more of the character. I like working with vectors, as I previously mentioned, because it's nice and easy for me to blow this character up for close-ups, pull them back, and it doesn't lose any definition. You have to watch the thickness of your brush. That will change with it. Once you're happy with a point, you might want to even do it after you finish your sketch file. Save as, and remember to keep saving your file so you don't lose any of your hard work. Okay guys, so that's if you want to create your character in harmony. Let's have another wee think. What if we create a character in Storyboard Pro? We can quickly sketch out this character. So I've quickly made this sketch using the grey colour. Perhaps you've even got a whole string of images that you want to create for your, maybe a comic book, feature film, whatever, what the case may be. You could refine this detail in Storyboard Pro. So let's just say we made a new vector layer. We made sure that we changed the colour to black. We might want to change our brush size ever so slightly. So I have one drawn that is the black layer, which will be the refined one, and the bottom layer, which is my grey layer. Now I could, from here, just do the grey layer and export it into Harmony for me to refine it and sketch it, or I could even refine it in Storyboard Pro and then export it. It's entirely up to yourself. What I do most of the time is I'll have my sketchy, so I'll have several images, and I'll go to File, I'll go to Export, and to Toon Boom. I'll call this character Character 2, just remember to put in details of where you want to save it, the name. If you're going to Harmony or Animate, I'm going to go to Harmony, and I'm going to use 12, so it's 9.2 or higher, and it's going to be the current scene. And if I press Export, good to go. Okie dokies. So that's exported. I can just close this down. Remember to save your Storyboard profile. And back in Harmony, what I'm going to do is I'm going to look for my Character 2 file. Change our colours. And just press yes. And there's our characters. So that's been exported in from Storyboard Pro. We can create a new layer by pressing the plus symbol in Harmony and go to Draw. We can rename it, add and close, and in here we can actually do a refined drawing of our storyboards. Okay guys, well I hope that's been helpful, and if you want any further tutorials or further details, please feel free to add it to the forum.